Welcome to our today's session. Today's session is Arduino based temperature monitoring and on off controller. Already we had seen temperature monitoring on serial monitor, but for that you require laptop or computer. So we want to make portable system, and for that we will monitor our temperature on LCD display. So we are adding LCD in our temperature monitoring system, as well as we will add Bluetooth so that you can monitor the temperature on our mobile. So you can say this is wireless temperature monitoring system. Plus we are adding on off feature. This is control action. If your temperature exceeds set point, then the relay will turn on or buzzer will turn on. And if your temperature is less than your set point, then relay turns off or buzzer turns off. So this is our today's application, hands-on on temperature monitoring and on-off controller. We are doing this step by step. I am not giving you direct program. So we will write program step by step so that you can understand the steps. So first we require the material. So first material is Arduino. In Arduino, we are using ADC. In Arduino, ADC is 10-bit ADC. And resolution of Arduino ADC is 5 millivolt. So whatever you are giving, if you want to get output 1, then your input should be 5 millivolt. So LM35 gives 10 millivolt, and if you want 1 for 10 millivolt, you have to divide it by 2 in your program. So we are using Arduino for a measurement of temperature as well as display, send the data. So you can say Arduino is heart of your system. Then you require LCD. LCD is 2x16. 2x16 means 2 line and 16 character. This is used to display temperature. Then next we require LM35. LM35 is temperature sensor. Its pin number 1 is VCC, 2 is output, 3 is ground. It gives 10 millivolt per degree Celsius output. Then we require a relay module or buzzer. So relay module is used to turn on and off action. So relay is device which is used to on and off action. Buzzer is also used to indicate that set point, to give sound if temperature exceeds above set point. And next we require Bluetooth HC05 module. The name of Bluetooth is HC05 and password is 1234. This is default name and default password. So using these components we are going to make our system. Previously we had seen this system LCD interfacing and LM35. So we are combining this first we will connect LM35, then we'll connect LCD and we'll observe the temperature on LCD. After that we'll connect Bluetooth and relay for control action. Same circuit we had used in home automation. So in this circuit you have to add LM35 and LCD, then your system will become complete. So we are using my shield. So this is my shield, it looks like this. So we are connecting LM35 at A0, or you can say at A0. Then we are using a relay for on off action, and we are using buzzer also for on off action. And this is my LCD. So LCD is used to indicate the temperature. So this is my system. The Arduino is below this shield. So before starting, you should know the pin diagram. So pin diagram is like this. So we are using RX0 and TX1 for Bluetooth, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 for LCD, 9 for buzzer and 10 for relay. We are not using 8, 11, 12, 13. So on this shield we will start our session. So we are going directly to our hands-on skill session. We will do it step by step. So our first step is open Arduino software. So I have to open the Arduino software. So this is my Arduino software. Again I will open my camera so that you can observe the simultaneous circuit. So this is my camera. So here we are using LCD. This is a relay. This is my LM35 temperature sensor. So it is used to measure the temperature, which is I had connected to A0 pin. On LCD right now there is nothing. Okay, I will turn on my outputs. Okay, so we have not written any code into this. So we'll start our session. So first we will measure the temperature on serial monitor. So for that, your first step, initialize the pin. So int sensor equal to 0. So we are connecting LM35 to 0 pin. Int T value means temperature value, or you can use T sensor, or you can say temperature sensor. T value, then in serial communication, in setup mode, we have to write down baud rate. So serial dot begin into bracket 9600. So I had set the baud rate. Now I have to write down the code for temperature measurement. So for that I will write the code. T value equal to analog read into bracket T sensor semicolon, and then delay into bracket 1000. So after every second temperature is measured. Now I have to click on upload. So I will click on upload. So it will ask the save. So I will write Cytronics temperature indicator, temperature indicator and controller, and then we are saving this. In our internship there are electrical branch students, so it is difficult for them to understand C, therefore we are going step by step. So how to observe the output? So for that we have to see on monitor, serial monitor. So on serial monitor you have to set baud rate 9600 and you have to observe the output. Okay, so tools, Arduino. So we had not given serial print command, so it is difficult to observe. We are not given serial print command, so it is not possible to observe the output. So for that, what I will do, I have to write down the serial print command. So for that, here serial dot print into bracket T value semicolon, and then I have to click on upload. So I am getting values 84, 60, 60, 59, but this is I want these values one line each. So after each display it should go to next line. So for that you have to give command serial.println and then you have to upload the code. So ln means go to next line. So see, when it displays 60 then 59, it goes to next line. Now I have not done calibration. Calibration means comparison with standard. LM35 gives 10 millivolt for 1 degree. But to get 1 as an output, you have to divide this by 2. Then see the output. So see, my output is 29, 29, 29. Now I want to display temperature equal to. So again I have to write serial dot print. I am not using ln. Now I want to display temperature equal to. So you have to write in ASCII code. To write the code in ASCII you have to use double inverted comma, and here you can write what you want to display. So temperature equal to, and then again click on upload. Whenever you are doing changes, you have to click on upload. So temperature equal to 41. So temperature equal to 29. So this is my temperature monitoring on monitor, which already we had studied in analog in operation. Now I want to add LCD to monitor this. So for that you have to write the LCD code. So what I will do, I will modify this code. So I will open file example basic, not basic, now we want liquid crystal, and from that you can use any program. Okay, so I will use Hello World. Now this is my ready-made program from my library. So what content you want? So I want these contents. These contents means LCD initialization. First you want LCD library. So this is my LCD library. So I will copy this LCD library, Control C copy, and I will put it at the top of my program. So hash include liquid crystal. Then I want these instructions, copy, and I will put it here. Okay, so here no need of this instruction also, we will write commands directly. So liquid crystal RS enable D4, D5, D6, D7. If you see in this, RS is pin number 2, enable is pin number 3, D4 is 4, D5 is 5, D6 is 6, D7 is 7. So you have to write down these pins there. So here I will write RS. RS is connected to pin number 2. Enable is connected to pin number 3. D4 is connected to pin number 4. D5 is connected to pin number 5. D6 is connected to D6. Say pin number 6, and D7 is connected to pin number 7. So just you have to write down this. So this is your first step. Second step, go to setup and use this instruction. Copy and paste. So LCD begins 16:2. So my LCD is 16:2. Then, so LCD is my initialized. Now here I have to write the code to display the value. So my first instruction is clear the LCD, and for that LCD dot clear is used. So this instruction is very important to clear the LCD. Whatever data present on LCD, that will be cleared. Then I want to display my temperature value. So I can use instruction LCD dot print into bracket T value. Okay, now we'll open our camera setting. So this is my camera. We are arranging three windows, one for serial communication, other for camera. So right now on LCD there is nothing displayed here. I will upload the code. So compiling, done uploading. See, here I am getting 44, here I am getting 44. 30 30 30 30. So now I will increase the temperature. So this is my temperature sensor. So I will increase the temperature by using lighter. So my temperature is increased, so it is 61. So whatever displaying on my serial monitor, same will be displayed on this. Now it is displaying only digits, but I want temperature equal to. So for that, here in my program I have to write like this. So LCD print double inverted comma temperature equal to, and then I have to click on upload. So temperature equal to, whatever displayed here, same will be displayed here. Temperature equal to. So we had monitored the temperature on serial monitor, then we had displayed the temperature on LCD. Now I want to add on off action. So for that, here I will write the code for on off action. So my code for on off action is like this. If you have to write down condition, else, if that condition is not satisfied, then do this. So I will write the code like this. If t value means temperature set point, temperature value is above set point. My set point I can write here like 50 degree. So if my temperature is above 50 degree, do this action, else do this action. So in this we are using relay and buzzer. So here I can write instruction digital write into bracket buzzer comma high, and here I can use digital write buzzer comma low. Okay, I have to initialize the buzzer. So I will write int buzzer. Buzzer is in small letters. So int buzzer equal to 9, because 9 pin is connected to buzzer. Again, buzzer is my output device. So I have to write down here pin mode. In pin mode, M is capital. Pin mode buzzer comma output semicolon. After writing code, you can go to tools and auto format. So automatically format is done. Now I will upload the code. So this is my buzzer. Right now we are not using relay. Okay, so done uploading. Right now my temperature is 30, so buzzer is off. If I increase the temperature, my buzzer should turn on. See, my buzzer turns on. So when temperature is becoming less than 50, my buzzer turns off. So when temperature reduces less than 50, my buzzer turns off. Now I want to add relay. Buzzer turns off. I want to add relay. So I can use int relay equal to 10 as variable. Then I have to initialize that relay as output. Now here I have to add action. Now if you are using only one instruction, then don't use curly brackets. But now I have to add relay, so I am using more than one instruction, so I have to use curly brackets. So for that, here you have to write down opening bracket and closing bracket. Similarly here also opening bracket and closing bracket. If you are writing single instruction, no need of curly brackets. But if you are writing more than one instruction, you require curly bracket. So relay on, and here relay off. And then I have to click on upload. So along with buzzer, I am using relay also. I will increase the temperature. So right now my temperature is 34, so relay is off, buzzer is off. If I increase the temperature, so as my temperature increases, my relay turns on as well as buzzer turns on. So when my temperature, this is my relay indicator. So when temperature reduces less than 50, this relay turns off, buzzer also turns off. So this is my temperature on off controller. Now this is my big program. This is my big program. I want to make it small, or I want to make it systematic. So what I will write? I will use functions. So we will design our own functions. So here in setup we will not write anything, or you can convert this into function also. So here I will write initialize system, and this is my function. So I will copy this. This is the name of my function, and in this function I will write like this. For computer engineering it is very simple, but for electronics, electrical engineering, it is new thing. I had written like this. So I had written after a loop, I had written this function. So function should start from void, and this is function, so no comma, semicolon is there. So this is my void initialize system program. In that I had initialized serial port, I had initialized LCD, I had initialized output pins. Then this program is for temperature measurement, so I can call the function like this, temperature measurement semicolon. So in temperature measurement I have to write like this, void temperature measurement opening bracket closing bracket, and in between that I have to write down this. So I had written separate program for temperature measurement. So it is at the below of this. After that, this is for serial monitor, or you can say it is for mobile. So display serially. So again, this is my program. So I have to write down this program below this, and the name of this program is display serially. Opening bracket and closing bracket. So I'm making program simple, so that after reading only loop you can understand what I had written. Now here I have to write display LCD. So it is at the bottom of this, void display LCD is the program. This is opening bracket and this is closing bracket. Then here I can write on off action. Delay I will include into this. And here I will write like this, void on off action. This is my opening bracket and this is my closing bracket. I will click on auto format tools auto format. Okay, so my programming is like this: void setup initialize system. In loop I will write like this: temperature measurement, display serially, display on LCD, take on of action, repeat the things. So while explaining the program at the time of oral, you have to explain only this. Your remaining program is at below. So this is my program. I will compile this so that I will find out the errors. So compiling, done compiling, there is no error, then I will upload it. So same program I had uploading, I am uploading. Done uploading. Right now my temperature is 50, it indicates 30, 31. So same program I had written in smaller format. So this is my main program, and for this sub programs I had written subroutines. So this is my subroutine for initialize system, this is my subroutine for temperature measurement, this is my subroutine for serial data, this is my subroutine for LCD display, this is my subroutine for on off action. So by using this technique you can reduce your program. So this is my only main program. Now I want to measure this temperature on my mobile. So for that I have to use Bluetooth. So this is my Bluetooth. The name of Bluetooth is HC05 and password is 1234. Now it has four pins: VCC, ground, RX, TX. So I will connect this Bluetooth. So VCC is connected to VCC, ground is connected to ground, and TX is connected to RX, and RX is connected to TX. So I had connected this Bluetooth. This light is blinking. This light is blinking. This light is blinking. Now I will take my mobile. In my mobile, I can open. I will open apps related to Bluetooth. So I will zoom this. So I am trying to clear this. Okay, so I will open my apps. So Bluetooth, so this is my Bluetooth apps. In that I have Bluetooth, Serial Pro, SPP port, Serial Monitor, you can use any app. So I will open this Bluetooth. Okay, so when I open this, it will scan the Bluetooth. It will scan the Bluetooth. Now see, here it indicates HC05. So I will select this HC05. Then it will ask whether to connect or not. Okay, so I will use connect. I will use connect. So when connect is there, I will do this action after. So this is my mobile. I will open Bluetooth SPP Pro. It will scan the Bluetooths. Scanning the Bluetooth. And here you are getting HC05. Now see, this light is blinking. This light is blinking. I will select SC05. It asking connect. When I click on connect, this light will blink very slowly. Right now it is blinking fastly. So I will click on connect. So connecting device. So I want byte stream mode. So here I am getting temperature values. Temperature. So this is my temperature value. Same value whatever is displaying on serial monitor, same value is displayed on this mobile, and same value will be displayed on display LCD. So this is wireless temperature monitoring system. If I increase the temperature by lighter, see my temperature increases. So this is wireless temperature monitoring system. So this is our today's session, wire temperature monitoring system. So thank you for watching this. Thank you very much. So you can make your own temperature on off controller using this system.